You are all beautiful, Mary, and the original stain is not in you. You are the glory of Jerusalem. You are the joy of Israel. You give honor to our people. You are advocate of sinners. O Mary, Virgin most prudent, Mother most merciful, pray for us, intercede for us with the Lord Jesus Christ. O God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant, we pray, that as you preserve her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, with the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please kneel. O most pure Virgin Mary, conceive
without sin, from the very instant you were entirely immaculate. O glorious Mary, full of grace, you are the Mother of God, the Queen of angels and of men. I humbly venerate you as the chosen Mother of my Savior, Jesus Christ. The Prince of Peace and the Lord of Lords chose you for the singular grace and honor of being his beloved Mother. By the power of his cross, he preserved you from all sin. Therefore, by his power and love, I have hope and bold confidence in your prayers for my holiness and salvation. I pray that your prayers will bring me to imitate your holiness and submission to Jesus and the divine will. Queen of heaven, I beg you to beg my Savior to grant me this request. My Holy Mother, I know that you were obedient to the will of God in making this petition. I know that God's will is more perfect than mine. So grant that I may receive God's grace with humility as you did. As my final request, I ask that you pray for me to increase in faith in our risen Lord. I ask that you pray for me to increase in hope in our risen Lord. I ask that you pray for me to increase in love for the risen Jesus. Amen. Amen. Day 3 of the Novena. And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word."
Prayer for the day. O my Queen and Mother, to you I offer myself humbly and heartily, that all my wishes and desires may be according to your holy will. To show you my devotion, I promise you that all my words, thoughts, and deeds will be done according to your will. Like a son who wholly trusts his own mother, O my Mother, preserve me and deigned me to all dangers, as you would protect your Son, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Mother of Christ,
pray for us.
Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
Mother of Mercy,
pray for us.
Mother of Divine Grace,
pray for us.
Mother of Hope,
pray for us.
Mother most pure,
pray for us.
Mother most chaste,
pray for us.
Mother inviolate,
pray for us.
Mother undefiled,
pray for us.
Mother most amiable,
pray for us.
Mother most admirable,
pray for us.
Mother of good counsel,
pray for us.
Mother of our Creator,
pray for us.
Mother of our Savior,
pray for us.
Virgin most prudent,
pray for us.
Virgin most venerable,
pray for us.
Virgin most renowned,
pray for us.
Virgin most powerful,
pray for us.
Virgin most merciful,
pray for us.
Virgin most faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of justice,
pray for us.
Seat of wisdom,
pray for us.
Cause of our joy,
pray for us.
Spiritual vessel,
pray for us.
Vessel of honor,
pray for us.
Singular vessel of devotion,
pray for us.
Mystical rose,
pray for us.
Tower of David,
pray for us.
Tower of ivory,
pray for us.
House of gold,
pray for us.
Ark of the covenant,
pray for us.
Gate of heaven,
pray for us.
Morning star,
pray for us.
Health of the sick,
pray for us.
Refuge of sinners,
pray for us.
Solace of migrants,
pray for us.
Comforter of the afflicted,
pray for us.
Help of Christians,
pray for us.
Queen of angels,
pray for us.
Queen of patriarchs,
pray for us.
Queen of prophets,
pray for us.
Queen of apostles,
pray for us.
Queen of martyrs,
pray for us.
Queen of confessors,
pray for us.
Queen of virgins,
pray for us.
Queen of all saints,
pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us.
Queen assumed into heaven,
pray for us.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
Queen of families,
pray for us.
Queen of peace,
pray for us.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Memorarium. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins. My Mother, to you do I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer me. Amen. The prayer of Pope Francis to Mary Immaculate. Virgin most holy and immaculate, to you, the honor of our people and our loving protector, do we turn with loving trust. You, all beautiful, O Mary, in you there is no sin. Awaken in all of us a renewed desire for holiness.
Mary, may the splendor of truth shine forth in our words, the song of charity resound in our works, purity and chastity abide in our hearts and bodies, and the full beauty of the gospel be evident in our lives. You are all beautiful, O Mary.
In you the Word of God became flesh. Help us always to heed the Lord's voice. May we never be indifferent to the cry of the poor, or untouched by the sufferings of the sick and those in need. May we be sensitive to the holiness of the elderly and the vulnerability of children, and always love and cherish the life of every human being.
You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you is the fullness of joy, born of life with God. Help us never to forget the meaning of our earthly journey. May the kindly light of faith illumine our days. The comforting power of hope direct our steps. The contagious warmth of love stir our hearts. And may our gaze be fixed on God, in whom true joy is found. You are all beautiful, O Mary.
Hear our prayer. Graciously hear our plea.
May the beauty of God's merciful love in Jesus abide in our hearts. And may His divine beauty save us, our city, and the entire world.
Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. Thank you.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
My brothers and sisters, concelebrating with me, our beloved priest from the Diocese of Maasin, Father Vincent, Father Lawrence, of course our Vice-Rector, Father Biel, and our Rector, Reverend Monsignor Rolly de la Cruz. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries in the Holy Eucharist on this third day of our novena, in preparation for the solemnity of the patroness of our cathedral, the Immaculate Conception, let us first call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. Let us pause for a short moment to examine our conscience. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, our Father, who willed that at the message of an angel, your word should take flesh in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, grant that we who pray to you and believe her to be truly the Mother of God may be helped by her interceding before you through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, the branch of the Lord will be luster and glory, and the fruit of the earth will be honor and splendor for the survivors of Israel. He who remains in Zion and he who is left in Jerusalem will be called holy, everyone marked down for life in Jerusalem. When the Lord washes away the filth of the daughters of Zion and purges Jerusalem's blood from her midst with a blast of searing judgment, then will the Lord create over the whole site of Mount Zion and over her place of assembly a smoking cloud by day and a light of flaming fire by night. For over all, the Lord's glory will be shelter and protection, shade from the parching heat of day, refuge and cover from storm and rain. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
I rejoice because they said to me, we will go up to the house of the Lord. And now we have set foot within your gates, O Jerusalem.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Jerusalem built as a city with compact unity. To it the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
According to the decree for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. In it are set up judgment seats, seats for the house of David.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May those who love you prosper. May peace be within your walls, prosperity in your buildings.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Because of my relatives and friends, I will say, peace be within you. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will pray for your good.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Please stand.
Come and save us, Lord our God. Let your face shine upon us, that we may be saved.
Alleluia,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus entered Capernaum, a centurion approached him and appealed to him, saying, Lord, my servant is lying at home paralyzed, suffering dreadfully. He said to him, I will come and cure him. The centurion said in reply, Lord, I am not worthy to have you enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I too am a man subject to authority, with soldiers subject to me. And I say to one, go, and he goes, and to another, come here, and he comes, and to my slave, do this, and he does it. When Jesus heard this, he was amazed and said to those following him, Amen, I say to you, in no one in Israel have I found such faith. I say to you, many will come from the east and the west, and will recline with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob at the banquet in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My brothers and sisters, good morning. Good afternoon. So just as God came down from heaven to be with us, I will also come down from this altar to be with you. The direction of our church at the present moment is synodality. Have you heard about it? Synodality. Ano bang mayroon sa synodality? Mayroong communion. We are in communion with one another. Participation. We participate in the mission. Communion, participation in the mission of the church. So yan ang synodality. We also have synodality in homily. So in homily, you have also communion with the preacher. Amen? By listening to him. And there is also participation. Kaya ngayon, by participation tayo. Okay? Because I will ask you some questions. And you participate by answering. Amen? And we fulfill our mission in homily. What is the mission in homily? That we understand and put into practice the Word of God. Tama? What's the use of being here, no? Having this liturgy of the Word and homily. And we do not understand. Baka iba nga dyan, hindi pa nakikinig eh. Habang nagbabasa yung ating mga lectors doon. So how can you understand the Word of God? You are not even listening. Sana hindi ito nangyayari sa inyo. No? So it's not only listening but also understanding. Because we cannot live the Word of God if we do not understand it. Amen? Okay. When it is said, that such quality is unique to that person. What does that mean? Or anybody can answer? If such quality is unique to that person, what does that mean? That means that that quality that person has, only that person has that quality. Kasi unique nga eh. Sa kanya lang yon. Correct? If such privilege is unique to that person, that means only that person has that privilege. And like Mary, ano bang special privilege ni Mary na ibinigay ng Diyos? Chosen as a mother, aside from that, the very basic, she had immaculate conception. Correct? That is her unique privilege of being immaculately conceived. Ibig sabihin, he was conceived she was free of original sin from the first moment of her conception. Okay? So, that is her unique privilege. And we are having this novena and later on solemnity because we are emulating her. We want to imitate her. Correct? Pero parang may problema eh. Kasi if Immaculate Conception is unique to the Blessed Virgin Mary, we cannot be having that privilege that she has. We're not conceived, no? Without original sin. O baka mayroon dito na conceived without original sin. Mayroon ba? Taas ang kamay. Wala. So, why are we having this novena to emulate when we cannot even emulate her? Because that privilege is only for her. Ano? Natahimik na kayo. Nagulat na kayo. Conceived without original sin. Eh, hindi naman tayo conceived. At bakit mag-imitate pa tayo? Iko-conceive pa ba tayo uli? Hindi na. Pero there is another way connected to the Immaculate Conception that we can imitate from the Blessed Virgin Mary. Blessed Virgin Mary was conceived without original sin and she lived without sin. Correct? So we cannot imitate her being free from conceived without original sin, but we can imitate her by living without sin. Amen? Mahina eh. Amen ba? So that is what we should do, no? To try as much as possible to live without sin. And that is also the call of our baptism. Correct? We were baptized so that we can be free from sin, that we can be cleansed from sin. So, what's that? If we are cleansed of sin, that means we have to continue try our best to be always without sin. That's why in baptism, if you can still remember, there are two promises that we have Aywan ko kung sinabi sa inyo ng mga magulang ninyo, ninong at ninang, dahil sila ang unang umako ng inyong pangako. Ito yung pangako natin para kapag sinunod natin, we will continue to be free from sin. O ano yung dalawang pangako? Our two baptismal promises. Ito yung ginagawa natin. We renew our baptismal promises. Kailan? Alin? Every Sunday. Kayo, sister? Very good. Every Easter Sunday. To remind us to continue living without sin. So what are these two? First, renunciation of Satan and sin. If you renounce Satan and sin, will you be living without sin? Yes, because you renounce Satan, you renounce sin. That is our first promise during our baptism. Kaya kung kayo ay magpapabinyag ng inyong anak, huwag niyong kalimutang sabihin. Sa experience ko sa pagbibinyag, hindi nasasabi ng mga magulang, mga ninong at ninang, ang inako nilang pangako sa kanilang anak. Hindi nila sinabi. Dapat sabihin niyo. Hindi po ba? Inako niyo eh. O kailan sasabihin? Sa first confession communion siguro, i-remind during confirmation. Hindi po ba? And second, aside from renouncing sin and Satan, we promise to profess our faith. Ibig sabihin, to live our faith. And if we do that, of course, we will be living without sin. Amen? Now, the readings for today also show us how to live without or free from sin. Our first reading is taken from where, from what book? From the book of Prophet Isaiah. So, how does it show us to be free or to live without sin? It says in the first reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, by going to the house of God, where God will instruct us in His ways, so that we may walk in His path. Nakuha nyo? So, i-instructan tayo about the ways of God. Bakit ginagawa yan? That is true. The readings, if you listen to the readings, you will get instruction from the Lord so that you can walk in His path. Correct? And if we are always walking in the path of God, will we be living in sin? No, we will be living free from sin. Amen? And from the gospel reading, it also shows us how to live without sin. And our gospel is taken from where? From the gospel according to Saint Matthew. Okay? Oh, according to this gospel, how can we live without sin? By having a humble faith, doing good to others, even to those in low social status. At saan natin nakita yon? Doon sa centurion. Diba? In-approach niya si Jesus because his servant was paralyzed, suffering dreadfully. And the Lord said, I will come and cure him. Anong sagot ng ano? A humble faith doing good even to those in low social status. Faith, saan natin makita doon sa sinabi niya? Just say the word. Sabi niya kay Lord. Just say the word. That means I have full trust in you. I have full faith in you. O saan naman yung humble? Lord, I am not worthy to have you under my roof. So what a humble faith. A humble faith doing good to others, even those in the lowest place of the society. Sino tong lowest place in the society? Yung servant niya. Di ba? Nung panahon na yon, walang value. They are in the lowest part of the society. But you know, even if he was a centurion, he still cared for his servant. Always a faith that is always, that is doing good to others. And if we have that faith, always doing good to others, will we be living with sin? No. We will be living free from sin because you are always doing what is good. So my brothers and sisters, first, what shall we do? Reject Satan and sin. Second, profess our faith. That means live our faith. Our faith should be our profession. And we go up to the house of God, which you are now doing in order to be instructed in His ways so that we can walk in His path. And last, we strive to have a humble faith doing good to others even in the lowest place in the society. And if we do those four, we will be living without sin, imitating our Blessed Virgin Mary. And at the same time, we are preparing for the second coming of the Lord. Amen.
Please stand.
My brothers and sisters, as we enter the season of Advent, we make our prayer to God our Father with all our hearts so that we can avail ourselves of the opportunity for a new beginning in grace. Let our response be, God of mercy, hear our prayer.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That those who minister in the church may bring the light of the gospel to all mankind. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That in our lives we may show the same love and compassion that the centurion had for his servant, to those who need our help. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That we may understand and accept those people who differ from us in race and religion. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That the elderly, the lonely, and the sick may receive the comfort of God's love in their distress. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may meet the Lord whom they eagerly awaited. Let us pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, help us to grow in our compassion and give hope to all those who touch our lives. May Advent bring us closer to you and each other as we wait in joyful hope for the second coming of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O God, our Father, these offerings, and by your power, change them
into the sacrament of salvation, in which fulfilling the sacrifices of the fathers is offered the true Lamb, Jesus Christ, your Son, born of ever Virgin Mary, in a way beyond all telling, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for the day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O God, our Father, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O God, our Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now let us pray to God our Father in heaven as Jesus taught us. Deliver us, O God, our Father, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await with blessed hope the coming, the second coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
My brothers and sisters, behold Jesus, who is coming at the end of time. Happy are we who are ready to receive him. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May Jesus bring all of us to everlasting life. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the mysteries we have received, O God our Father, always show forth your mercy in us, that we who commemorate in faith the mother of your Son may be saved by his incarnation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before the final blessing is given, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Monsignor Nestor Serbo for presiding over this third Novena Mass. We are privileged and honored by his presence. Monsignor Nestor was a former rector of the Manila Cathedral, and he is celebrating, together with Monsignor Jerry Santos, his 40th anniversary as a priest. Not only silver, but 40th. I think it's ruby. So, Monsignor Nestor, thank you for coming over. Palakpakan po natin siya. And as a token of our appreciation, please accept a replica of the image of the Immaculate Conception enshrined at this sanctuary.
Thank you.
Also, at this point, I would like to thank once more the Diocese of Maasin, represented by Father Mark and Father Lawrence. Now I got it right. No, I've been calling him Father Jay. No? For bringing the original image of Our Lady of Assumption to Metro Manila and to Luzon, especially to the Manila Cathedral. That is the original image, and according to the bishop, Bishop Cantillon, that will be the last time that the original will go out of the shrine. Kaya ho, we are very lucky to have this last opportunity to see the original. Maybe this is the 75th year of the dogma of the Assumption. Maybe on the 100th year of the dogma of the Assumption, we can still see the original being brought here. But who knows, no? We may not be around anymore. So, Father Mark and Father Lawrence, please express to Bishop our appreciation for including the Manila Cathedral in one of the legs of the pilgrimage that you underwent. At 2 p.m., the image will be leaving and be brought to Baclaran Church, and it will stay there for a few days, and then the image, together with Father Mark and Father Lawrence, will go home to Maasin in time for the celebration of Christmas. So, maraming maraming salamat po. Palakpakan po natin ang dalawang paring ito. At sa ating mahal na ina, Viva Maria!
Viva Maria!
Just a few announcements, there is an ongoing exhibit of collections of Father Jenny Diwa, the collection of Belen, no, personally owned by Father Jenny Diwa in those two chapels. So, tingin lang ha, pera hawak, no? And also, of course, the schedule of Novena Masses, 12:10 from Monday to Friday, 7:30 in the morning on Saturday, and 10 in the morning on Sunday. And on December 9, our Masses on the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception will be at 7:30, 12:10, and 6 p.m. Thank you po. At salamat po sa inyong pagparito kahit na hindi maganda ang panahon at pagdalo sa ating Novena Masses. Maraming maraming salamat po.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God continue to bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is over. Go and rejoice, because when we continue to live without sin like the Blessed Virgin Mary, we are ready for the second coming of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.